1 degree Celsius. I wish I could raise the air temperature in the room where you are by 1 degree. I bet that most of you wouldn't feel that slight temperature difference because it's hardly perceptible by the human body. 1 degree corresponds to the mean warmings recorded since 1900 on Earth. According to the global scientific consensus, this warming is mostly related to human activities and especially to greenhouse gas emissions since the Industrial Revolution. This 1 degree difference can seem insignificant, and yet it has tremendous effect on Earth and especially on glaciers. This tiny warming has generated a worldwide glacier decline that is unprecedented in history. Glaciers are disappearing, and their disappearance makes visible the invisible. It is making concrete and tangible the current climate change that is hard to perceive in most of ecosystems and so hard to grasp for so many of us. But I'm not here to show you one more time that glaciers are among the first victims of climate change. I would like to show you that glaciers are much more than melting ice. They have a key influence in our day-to-day life, even in communities really far away from them. Like bees, they are keystones of the Earth's systems where life, and especially human life, has recently evolved. And for that, they must be saved. But first, what are glaciers? Glaciers form in cold regions where permanent snow accumulations progressively transforms into ice by densifying under its own weight. Glaciers flow on lands, like rivers of ice. They are present on almost all continents and even cover most of the lands by forming two continental ice sheets in Antarctica and Greenland. Glaciers have always been part of my life. I am both Swiss and French, as you can probably hear. I grew up at the foot of the Alps with the Mont Blanc as the backdrop. I have been studying their dizzy evolution for more than 10 years and work now at the frontier between science and nature conservation in order to protect our only home, the Earth. I especially work for the International Union for Conservation of Nature. One of our missions is to safeguard the most important natural protected areas on Earth that are on the UNESCO's World Heritage List and to help humanity to respect its commitment to transmit their invaluable richness to future generations. Last year, together with Matthias Huss, a glaciologist from ETH Zurich and the University of Fribourg, and my colleague Elena Osipova, we led the first study on World Heritage glaciers. We showed that World Heritage sites shelter about 10% of the 200,000 glaciers on Earth. Some of them have very iconic record holders, like the highest on the Everest, or one of the fastest and largest iceberg producers in Greenland. The study painted a true picture of their decline on our warming planet. Most of these glaciers have lost a large amount of their mass since 1900, and some, for instance, in Africa or in the Alps, even completely disappeared already. Even though these glaciers are under a special protection status, they respond exactly the same ways as unprotected neighbors. Indeed, the nature conservation laws used to restrict human activities in these sites are powerless to limit the consequences of a global phenomenon like climate change. We also use the baseline glacier evolution model developed by Matthias to anticipate their response to future climatic projections. In the most pessimistic scenario, failing to drastically cut our greenhouse gas emissions will lead to the melt of around 60% of their current volume by 2100. This warming will very likely generate the extinction of most of the glaciers on Earth. In the most optimistic scenario, we can still save around 65% of the current volume by the end of the century if we cut rapidly our greenhouse gas emissions. Under this limited warming, ice melt will progressively curb in future, allowing most of these sites to conserve glaciers. In the face of these scenarios, as glaciologists and nature conservationists, we asked ourselves three simple questions. First, do we have to protect and save glaciers? Glaciers are more than just great climatic barometers and some of the most amazing natural features. Like keystone species, they have a disproportionately large impact on Earth and deliver unique services to ecosystems and humans. For instance, glaciers, and especially ice sheets, have a huge impact on our seas. If this ice mass were to melt, it would generate a 66-meter sea level rise globally that will dramatically affect coastlines. Glaciers and ice sheets also have a major influence on the climate systems. They act as giant coolers by reflecting solar radiations, by producing cool water and air masses, or by influencing oceanic water circulations. They have a key influence on the global mild climatic conditions that we enjoy on Earth. Their melt will contribute to reaching a point of no return for our planet that will turn it into a giant outhouse. On land, glaciers influence the flow and abundance of water and sediment far downstream. The fresh water they deliver, especially in the summer, is key to support the life in ecosystems or in societies. It's also locally vital for agriculture, hydropower, or tourism. In some regions, glacier decline will lead to water scarcity. It will impact countless communities, even where people have never seen a glacier with their own eyes. We owe a lot to glaciers. They influence the shape of continents and oceans, the distributions of climates, of fresh water, and thence of life conditions on Earth. Their melting will contribute turning the current emerging climate crisis into the biggest social, migratory, economic, environmental crisis in the history of humanity. Imagine the impact of sea level rise of freshwater scarcity on societies or on ecosystems. Imagine the costs and the conflicts related to the forced migrations of millions of people. I hope you are starting to grasp now why we have to save the glaciers from their extinction that we are responsible for. The second question we asked ourselves was, how can we protect glaciers? There are local solutions that are being developed to limit glacier melt, like installing tarp or producing artificial snow at their surface. But how practicable or scalable can be these methods on 10% of unstable lands all over our planet? And more importantly, they only try to limit the symptoms, ice melt, without addressing the root cause of the problem, climate change. The truth is there is no shortcut to limit glacier melt and its consequences globally. The only effective way is to mitigate climate change by cutting our greenhouse gas emissions. Ice melt is inevitable over the next decades, but saving a large amount of glacier ice is still possible if we act decisively. According to scientific modeling, if all states cut emissions in line with the Paris Agreement of 2015, around 80% of the current global glacier volume on Earth, around 65% of the one of World Heritage glaciers, and 35% of the one of Alpine glaciers can be preserved by the end of the century. We have to do it for our children. Third, how can we accelerate our fight against climate change? Mitigating climate change represents the greatest challenge humankind has ever faced. It will require a globally unprecedented shift in how we live on Earth and how we consume its very limited resources. We are increasingly aware of climate change and of its dramatic consequences, but our collective reaction to date is still desperately insufficient. Here again, glaciers have a key role to play, because these disappearing giants are the perfect whistleblowers that can help us to step up actions. Their indisputable decline makes some alarming consequences of climate change visible, understandable, and predictable. While the world leaders fail to respect their climatic commitments or take too long to grasp the severity and the urgency of this crisis, more and more citizens and organizations are turning to glaciers to trigger that mindset shift that will lead us to change our ways. We have heard of recent symbolic glacier funerals or legal actions to give right to glaciers, but a popular initiative that was launched last year in Switzerland to save the glaciers is giving citizens an incredible power over the matter. If we, the Swiss people, vote to save the glaciers, the national commitments pledged during the Paris Agreement and the carbon neutrality target set for 2050 will be inscribed in the Swiss Constitution. This clearly shows that efforts to save glaciers and to fight climate change are one and the same. They can join forces in what is probably so far the most important moment in the history of humanity. We have at least two things in common with glaciers. We need specific climatic conditions to thrive on Earth, and our composition is mostly made of water. Thanks to their greater sensitivity to climatic variations, these fragile giants remind us again, before it's too late, that there is only one sustainable way to live on the planet that we share with them, by respecting nature. And it all starts with us right now.